Hey everybody, Brenda Edelman here. Sorry I'm a few minutes late. I was going to do this on my computer. I was all set and then I didn't see the Facebook Live button on my forgiveness page. I don't know why. I think they might be rolling it out on maybe in different groups or different pages, but it's not there. I did one on my Brenda Edelman page and and that was no problem. But for some reason, the Forgiveness and Freedom page doesn't have a way for me to do a Facebook Live yet. And I was on Chrome, because I do know that for some reason it's not working on Firefox. So anyway, I wanted to talk about forgiveness, right? I actually call Friday Forgiveness Friday because I like to tap into the power of forgiveness on Fridays because there's always more to do. And I have a very big story, and my hope is always that it will inspire you to know that forgiveness is for you. So, I have a lot of people that email me all the time that tell me about certain things that have happened in their lives and why they can't forgive. And I've led quite a few workshops also where people show up with reasons to not forgive. So I want you to think about what is your reason for not forgiving. But it usually comes to things like what you've lived through is just was unforgivable. And so I'm never about taking away what you've gone through. You know, I know personally a lot of people have gone through so much that you would think is unforgivable on the one hand. But my teaching, I guess, is that I want to reframe the definition of forgiveness so that you really know that it's for you, it's not for the other person. Because what happens is when we hold on to the unforgiveness, it's like poisoning ourselves, poisoning ourselves with the thoughts that we think about the other person. In some weird way, we're bonded to them because we don't let go of our feelings of resentment or feelings of a need to punish and things like that. So I'm going to share my story. And I did say in my group, The Naked Storyteller, that I was going to talk about the specific how I forgave my father. Because a lot of people say, forgive, forgive, forgive. Forgive is not, if it's said just like that, it's kind of, I mean, where's the compassion in that? It's like there's an opportunity to really understand the what someone's going through, why they maybe can't forgive, because of the misunderstanding that if they forgive, maybe someone will hurt them again, step all over them again. Like it's not about forgiveness and letting someone hurt you again or letting someone else hurt you again. It's about having a really wonderful sense of self and setting healthy boundaries, okay? So for those of you who don't know my story, again, this is Brenda Edelman. I have been sharing it for over a decade. I share it about 7 years ago. I stopped sharing it for me. Before then, I had to share it for me. It was still part of my healing process. And about 7 years ago, I had this amazing thing happen. It was, hey Yvonne, welcome. I started sharing about my story because I had to. It was like I needed to kind of get it out of me. And I did it in a very creative way. Healthy way. I created a one-person show where I inhabit the characters of my story. And I was doing the show back in 2007 at a very big theater conference that my brother, actually in Europe, was hosting. And he saw the show live for the first time. And we did the Q&A for the show after the show together. And there was something that happened in that moment where art and life came together and this incredible healing took place, having my brother witness the story of our lives, but from my perspective in a stage show, and then being on stage together answering questions and showing him my life in this way, since we never really talked about things. But here in a one-person show, I could express myself fully and he could see what I had lived through. Hey, Pamela. And in that moment on stage, it was so incredible. I still remember my like seven-year-old, I think he was seven at the time, nephew was in the audience because he didn't know how my mom had died, and he got the funny, he got the humor, he got the humor in the show, which was awesome. But it was this moment of having my family there, having my family witness my story, my brother being on stage with me, doing a Q&A together, the painting of my mother in the background. It was this moment of life and art coming together, and something healed in me. And from that point on, when I returned to the States, I was no longer performing the show because I had to, in the way of, I have to heal myself, I have to get this out, I have to, you know, I know this doesn't make sense, but for me there was an element of unconsciously, I have to heal my mother. Now, my mother was already dead, but it was like, I have to save people in the audience who are dealing with something like I was. Like, there was something unconscious underneath my performances before then, but in 2007, all of a sudden that shifted when I did the show in Austria, and my brother was there, and we did the Q&A together, and something incredibly healing happened. And from then on, now I perform my story and I share my show as a gift. Oh, thank you. As a gift for other people, because I know when I'm honest, when I'm real, when I'm true, when I'm raw, that it's going to help other people, but that I'm not responsible for them. So for those of you who don't know what happened, since I teach people about storytelling, and let me tell you, in 1995, my father, whom I adored, shot and killed my mother, who I adored. And then within months, he moved in with my mother's sister, my aunt, and they got married. And he did go to jail. So my show is called My Brooklyn Hamlet because of the analogy to Hamlet. Because at the time, I felt so alone. I felt so damaged. I felt like nobody could understand what I was going through. But in Shakespeare's Hamlet, I knew there was a character that went through something like me. In Hamlet, his father is killed by his uncle, and then his uncle marries his mother. And in Hamlet, it's all about revenge and everybody dies. But my show, my life, is about the power of forgiveness. So let me talk a bit about forgiving my father. I couldn't forgive him for years. Like, in my head, I did the thing of what other people say, forgive, forgive, forgive. You know, you have to forgive. You have to forgive. You know, that's in the back of our minds. And sometimes it's tricky because we can think that we've forgiven, but we really haven't. So I would vacillate between forgiving my father in a way of, well, it wasn't even forgiveness. This is the distinction. It was more like, okay, this happened, so I have to accept it, even though I don't want to accept it. That's actually not forgiveness, but it's acceptance. Acceptance is good. But I would vacillate between hating him and loving him. And I almost felt like I had to hate him to keep my boundaries up with him, because he never really took responsibility. Never really showed remorse. Just kind of said things like, the past is the past, can't talk about it, things like that, right? And then he went to jail on a plea bargain, so I didn't get to know what exactly happened. Yeah, much easier said than done, Pamela. Yeah. Yeah, and the thing is, that's why I want to talk about how you forgive versus just saying to forgive. So I'm going to tell you a few things of what I did, the process, because the first, I mean, it literally took me like 6 years. To really get to a place of forgiveness. Even longer than that, because, you know, my mom died in 1995. I went to get my master's degree in spiritual psychology, and I graduated there in 2001, so I was doing a lot of forgiveness work there. I started writing my show, and then it wasn't until 2003 that I did a lot of forgiveness before 2001. I remember the date because I ended up taking my dad to court for wrongful death. So what I will say is, forgiveness doesn't mean rolling over and letting someone continue to hurt you or lie to you, right? Because I actually forgave my father and I took him to court for wrongful death. So let me talk about that process. So to forgive my father, thank you. So to forgive my father, what I had to do to really forgive, because a lot of us say, oh, I'm going to forgive that, or I've forgiven that, or it's not affecting me now, but it can affect you even if the person's not in the same state with you. To forgive him, the biggest thing I'll say for today is that I had to bring my unconscious feelings to conscious awareness so that I could know how they were affecting me, because so many of us live our lives by pushing something in the background. So what that meant for me, and this is something you can apply here if any of you are dealing with this, is I took a picture of my dad out and I put it up in the place where I was living at the time, almost like an altar, And I would look at it at least once a day so that I could bring my thoughts about him to the surface. And I would rate it, like, let's say one was, oh my God, this, my day is freaking wrecked because I'm thinking about him, I hate him. And let's say 10 was, wow, I actually, did I have coffee? I'm like shaking a little bit. And 10 would be like, wow, I'm having a great day. I thought about him, but I wish him well, right? I didn't get there for a very long time, but it's about being conscious every day instead of just back then when I was doing that work. I think that was like maybe 2000 or 1999. I would think about him so that it wasn't like, oh, if he called, because I was on and off again and in communication with him, he'd call and my whole day would be wrecked. But once I started doing this exercise and taking my power back, I would be able to look at that picture and say, how am I feeling today? And then I could do some freeform writing or journaling so that I could move through the emotions. That was really important. And I did that for at least 30 days so I could like then look back and say, this really helped. Oh, this didn't help. Oh, I'm still so angry. And then do the anger work. If I had to do a healthy anger work release, which is another thing I'll talk about, because so people say forgive, and they also, it's almost like they want you to stuff your anger. Or, you know, certainly a lot of us women are brought up to stuff our anger. And I stuffed my anger. I stuffed it with food. I stuffed it with overworking out. I stuffed it with, you know, overdoing, overthinking. And I really feel like it took so long for me to really let go and forgive fully because I didn't get in touch with my anger. So the anger work's really, really important. And just one way that you can work with that on your own is to do something called freeform writing, which is writing that you do where you do not read it over. You're literally writing the stress out of your body. And in layers, you don't read it over because then you would be anchoring the energy back in, you know? So you can also work with a therapist. Sometimes they do anger workshops in areas where it's, you know, led by therapists, things like that. You know if you can handle it yourself, right? I do have a Kindle book that has my three-step process in it. It's called, very aptly, My Father Killed My Mother and Married My Aunt, Forgiving the Unforgivable, that has my three-step forgiveness process, and it's a workbook and a memoir. So the reason why I say, and I started this with saying that also to become a better storyteller, you have to forgive, is because if I had that anger still in me that was like completely unconscious, it means that there'd be parts of me that I couldn't share because I wouldn't feel healthy enough to share it. Or if I shared it, it would come out in a way where I wasn't being a pro. I was putting my energy on other people instead of working my inner process so that if I want to bring anger up, I'll bring it up. But it's not because it's in charge of me. And then the other thing I wanted to say, let's see, people often assume that if you had forgiven someone, you would want a relationship with them. Oh, I know. That is, and that's a misconception. Like I said, I forgave him, and I took him to court for wrongful death against my mother, and because I did, he skipped town. I never saw him again, which was good. It was a healthy boundary. You know, sometimes it's hard to set a boundary. That was a really, really good boundary to set. I actually teach when you forgive that you absolutely have to know what a healthy boundary is at the same time so that you don't have a relationship with someone who, let's say, shows no remorse. You can have a relationship if the person takes responsibility, shows remorse, and takes a, you know, is accountable, but if not, I never encourage that. Well, I don't do it, and I don't encourage it for my clients. So the other thing that was interesting is that I had to forgive myself, which you think, why would I have to forgive myself for my father killing my mother? So it's not logical, right? People have a lot of guilt when someone dies, right? Like, what could you have done differently? For me, it was, trying to get the lighting a little better. For me, it was feeling like I was daddy's little girl and that I should have seen it. I should have seen it coming, even though I was an adult at the time. I should have seen it coming. I should have been able to somehow help my mother, heal my mother, have her make different decisions. And so I actually had to forgive myself a lot and understand that the dynamic of the relationship, I was daddy's little girl, and that I didn't mean I was guilty of something, and it didn't mean that I was responsible for my mother's death. I actually did something called the healing of memories exercise that I do with clients sometimes that really helped me go back to a moment in time. And I even have a scene from this in my one woman show, a moment in time where I really took my dad's side and I changed it in my mind's eye. I forgave myself. I released it from having that memory have a hold on me. So that was really powerful. And that's a really powerful tool to like go back. And again, it's always about bringing unconscious thoughts to conscious awareness so that you can love those parts inside you that hurt, right? So let me just know, do you have any questions? And again, let me just say to close, you know, the self-forgiveness is so important also as a storyteller, because if you don't love yourself, and a lot of people are telling their stories and trying to be more real on camera, the camera catches everything. So if you feel guilty about something, even if it's nothing to be guilty for, sometimes it comes across as you're hiding something. Or oftentimes people wear their anger, they wear their insecurity on their face, on their body language. So that's why it's so important to do this self-forgiveness work, which when you do it, then it leads to, you know, self-honor, right? So I guess what I'll say here is if anybody wants to do a one-on-one with me, I do offer one-on-one forgiveness sessions. I guess I'll put information below on that. And also, if you just have any questions, you want to ask how to do one of the exercises I said in here, please just ask away. Okay, thank you so much for showing up. I'm so glad you ladies are here. I think the forgive and love yourself is so important. Yeah, it's so important, because what happens is when we get angry at ourselves, we mostly tend to beat ourselves up. Like we should know we should know better. And that's actually what I say. It's a call to love. When something happens that we think we should have known better, like notice how you feel and what your mind does right away, and immediately go into how can I love myself through this? How can I learn the lesson? How can I love myself? How can I not repeat the action? Do things differently and make self-honoring choices. That's actually what we're being called to do in that moment, instead of beat ourselves up, which is what most of the planet does, you know, and then that causes more negativity, right? So anyway, thank you guys so much for being here. And leave comments. And I'll probably see you, both of you are in the Naked Storyteller group. I don't know if anybody else is on here. But thank you so much for coming. Let me know if you found this helpful. Okay? And if you're going to do some of the exercises I mentioned. Okay, bye.